So yeah, every HTML document starts with HTML.
Okay.
Browsers are very forgiving. They will often just like try to make something work, even if you don't have the appropriate structure. But it's
like
best to follow
practices.
It.
Okay.
So then you've got your header heading.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is stuff that's not really necessarily displayed on the page. So you've got the title. You've got some sort of like loading of attributes.
Okay. So wait, this linking style / main, that's where it gets the CSS that we were modifying earlier.
Yeah. This stuff seems to be about like mobile stuff. So it's not super relevant to figuring out how things work, at least on the web page. And then we've got the beginning of the body, which is really like what's shown on the page.
Okay. And so, I mean, this is, every time I look at HTML, I just see this like wave of, you know, indent and less, more indented, less indented. How are you, what are you thinking about when you're seeing this sort of structure?
Yeah, so basically I want to look for two things that are at the same indentation level, and that tells me that that's, so this is the beginning of the block and this is the end of the block.
Okay.
You also get this little closing guy to say, you know, I opened this div and now I close this div.
Now, what is a div? Why is it called a div?
I actually don't know why it's called a div, but divs are sort of the basic building block of websites.
Just
they're just sort of a thing,
okay.
a container for stuff. there are sort of special kinds of things, like A is usually a link.
Okay.
You've got forms.
What about, so can you go back up a bit?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they all have this thing, this class container, class heading. So is that class just for the, so that when I'm writing the CSS file and I want to say everything that's a container is blue? Is that what it's for?
Pretty much, yeah. The JavaScript can also use these classes.
Okay.
It's basically just a shorthand for saying like these are similar things. These should look the same. You could have more specific rules for like just a single one with an ID.
Mm-hmm.
But mostly, yeah, it's for the CSS. You could just have all of the styles inlined, but that's
messy. So that would be like every time I had what I wanted to be a container, I'd have to say
you'd have
hey,
to have
the color's
all
blue.
Of the,
Okay. Yeah, I don't want to do that. Okay, so we have our divs. What are these H1s?
That's a header.
Okay. P. What's P?
Paragraph.
Okay.
I just sort of mix the spacing around it, standardized.
But it seems like the div is the really structural thing, and this is the P's and the A's are just sort of like
things that go inside divs usually. Yeah, so divs can just be like a blob of text. They can be a container that holds a bunch of different blobs of text. Mm-hmm. It's really sort of like the basic building block of HTML.
Right. Let me play around a bit and see if I can, you know, make some changes.
All right.